إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وتركنا على المحاجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فاللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد في الأولين، وصلي وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد في الآخرين، وصلي وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد في كل وقت وحين، اللهم أمين. يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ثم أما بعد، dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today inshallah we were talking about this pandemic, which all world talking about it. With all these bad or strange circumstances which we live, we have to know the reason of this thing. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this evil? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us an evil in general? It's not this virus only. I'm talking about all kinds of evil. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it? The only answer you will find it in al-Islam, in al-Quran al-Azim. And this is the difference between Muslim people and non-Muslim people. Between mu'mineen and non-mu'mineen. This is the difference. Because we have the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the evil to let you differentiate between the good things and the bad things. If we don't have evil in our life, how would we know the good things? If you wanted to feel the sweetness of cold water, you have to drink this water after thirsty. If you wanted to feel the sweetness of food, you have to eat this food after hunger. Then you will feel the sweetness of this thing. تعرف الأشياء بضدها. In the opposite way, you can differentiate the thing which you want to know. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the evil to let you appreciate al-khayr. If you have good times, but you have hard times before these good times, you will appreciate the good times which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ ضَلَّ مَن تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاكُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ أَعْرَضْتُمْ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ كَفُورًا. That Allah here is describing those people who Allah gave them hardship time in the sea. When they are sailing in the sea, in the ocean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them with bad circumstance, with hardship time. The first thing they will make it, they will ignore all these idols and they will call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But after Allah survived them in the land, they come back to make ma'asi, they come back to disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they come back to ignore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, why you obeyed me in hardship time, and now in regular time, you just move away from me. Why? I can give you also hardship time in the land. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could make damage in these people on the land and could also send upon them hasiba. Hasiba means is the small stones which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent on the people of Lut alayhi salam. You imagine, now you are fearing from drowning in the sea, I will drown you with the small stones on the land. It's same punishment. Because this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who owns all this kind of punishment, all this kind of evil. You have to declare that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable of every single thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created all these things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who will take it. This is His decision. He decided this before He created us. Before He created the heavens and earth, He decided this. يعني وباء, this virus, we will see it. We will live in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided this before He created al-ard was-samawat. Dear brother and sister, we have to make two things only. Number one, we have to put the right iman, the right aqeedah, the right knowing of Allah in our hearts first. We have to declare this, we have to live, we have to feel this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one who has the ability and the power subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all these circumstances and to change all these circumstances. If you have this belief in this aqeedah in your heart, then you will be okay. This is the first part we have to make it. To know that Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. This is a story having Allah has mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah. That is, subhanAllah, it's similar situation. Same situation. He came to destroy town. To dead town. Khawiya ala urushiha. And he found in this town every single thing died. The walls fallen down. There is no trees. There is no life in any single thing. Him and his donkey and his food only. Three things alive in this town. Thumma tasa'al. He was wondering how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will revive this town back. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the life in this town again. Every single thing is dying, every single thing is destroyed. And he was wondering, Allah, أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will revive this thing after death, which I'm seeing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the time to teach him that something. And now we have to learn from this story. فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ مِئَةَ عَامٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused the death upon him and his donkey 100 years. And Allah left the food fresh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revived him first. And he let him saw the fresh food. And Allah asked him, كم لبثت? How long did you die? He said, يوما أو بعض يوم. Day or half day. He told him, فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنى وانظر إلى حمارك. Look at your food and look at your donkey. You will feel the difference. And you will find that time, the ability of me as a God. Then he saw his food and he found his food fresh. And he found his donkey died. He just found small crumbs of his donkey's dead bones. And he said, this is years, but the food is fresh. How is it? This is the ability of Allah, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah revived the donkey in front of him. وَانْظُرْ إِلَى الْعِظَامِ كَيْفَ نُنْشِزُهَا ثُمَّ نَكْسُوهَا لَحْمًا. Allah combined the bones of donkey in front of his eyes, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dressed these bones with the flesh of donkey, and Allah revived this donkey in front of his eyes. Life. Reviving. Subhanallah. Qala, after all these things, أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Now I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable of everything. Now I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-qadir. He knows this after 100 years. And now we have 100 days. But alhamdulillah, we know this, that Allah عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And we have to put this thing in our hearts, dear brothers and sisters. We have to put this belief in our hearts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable of everything. From His names, Al-Qadir, Al-Muqtadir, Al-Qadir. Al-Qadir, Al-Muqtadir Al-Qadir. Why Allah put His names and His attributes in Al-Quran and Sunnah? To just read it? No, to believe in it. وَذَمِيرُ فِي الْقَادِرِ Al-Muqtadir Al-Qadir. The whole these names imply that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has all authorities, has all powers, has everything. He owns every single thing in this life. And He has this destiny before He created us. إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ He created every single thing in destiny. For this is His plan, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to know this to bring the comfort in our hearts. You have to bring the iman in your heart first. And iman in the right way. التَوَكُّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى To rely upon Allah, you have to know who is Allah you want to rely upon. Who is this God? Al-Alim, Al-Qadir, ala kulli shayin qadir. Another story, Al-Asr ibn Wa'il, one from the polytheists at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he took old bones, dead bones also, and he made like this in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make them like crumbs, and he told Rasulullah, does your Lord revive this again? You try to tell us there is hereafter, and Allah will revive all these bodies like this, bones, Allah will revive it again. Rasulullah couldn't answer him until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this great ayat in Surah Yaseen. وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَثَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقًا قَالَ مَنْ يُحْيِي الْعِظَامَ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ قُلْ يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَهَا أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٌ He gave Rasulullah example. Does your Lord will revive this after death? And Allah told him, Rasulullah, told this guy and told your people, the one who created this from the beginning, able to create it again. What is the difficult? To revive something or to create it from the beginning, from nothing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created these people, and after the death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala able to revive it again. It's easy for it. He created it from the beginning. قَالَ مَنْ يُحْيِي الْعِظَامَ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ Say, يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَهَا أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ This thing, the one who revived this, the one who created it from the beginning. وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٌ He is all-knowing about every single thing He created. SubhanAllah. Pandemic, viruses, diseases, amrad, anything He knows, SubhanAllah. But the first thing we have to declare and we have to feel, relying upon Allah, al-tawakkul Allah, which Allah, al-alim, al-qadir, al-qadir, al-muqtadir. We have to learn the names of Allah, to know who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we worship, that we worship subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-qadir, the capable of everything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه ثم توبوا إليه. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله طبعا for this circumstances I would like to talk with you more about the ability of Allah The Qudra of Allah, the examples which Allah gave us in His guidance, which we have to look at it and understand it, because this is the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the category of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the category of life, which we have to look at it, to understand the stories there, like this guy which I told you. He had same wondering, which many people have it now. How Allah will revive this thing? How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take this disease? How? How? Allah taught this guy in 100 years. But we have to know this, that Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. Dear brothers and sisters, my advice for you, now we're talking about relying, something aqidah, something in the heart, something you have to feel. Now we're talking about some actions we have to do. Aqidah wa actions. Amanu wa amalu salihat. Believe and deeds. Aqidah, to think, to believe something, and to make behavior. Yalla, make bad actions. What is the actions we have to make? 5 fortifications and 5 supplications. 5 fortifications and 5 supplications. Just to memorize all of them and apply it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you and us. The first one from fortifications, tahsinat. You have to wash your hand every day, many times, with all kind of soap and all this stuff. This is number one. Number two, you have to stop the hugs and shake hands. It's number two. Number three also, you have to strengthen your immunity, like vitamin C, orange juice, all these healthy food. This is number three. Number four, if you have any kind of coughs or any kind of influ, just stop to come to the masjid. Stay in your home, because there is 2 hadith talking about this thing. The Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to him and they asked him for an excuse to don't attend Salat al-Jama'ah. They asked Rasulullah, companions or Rasulullah, in hadith al-Sahih. So he told them, you have 2 conditions. If you wanted to stop to come to Salat al-Jama'ah, you can make it, but with 2 conditions. Al-Khawf wal-Marad. Fearness, sicknesses. That's it. If you have sickness, if you have fearness, you cannot come out. If you don't like to come to the masjid, aslan, you have to still come to the masjid. Because if you come to the masjid, maybe you will make all these adwa and all these stuff. Also another thing, Rasulullah ﷺ prohibited those who are eating garlic and onion to come to Salat al-Jama'ah. Imagine garlic and onion. Why? Because they will harm. They will harm the people, those who are praying to Allah. They wanted to focus and they wanted to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said in the Quran, خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ. Take your zina, take your good clothes and put this good clone and come to the masjid in the best view. Then if you eat onion or garlic, Rasulullah said, don't come to the masjid. Imagine if you have influ or all this stuff. Just stay in your home. Take your rest and come. After 14 days, come to the masjid again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you this rukhsah. Okay? Even now, we have 4 things. The 5th thing is, if you want to come to the masjid, come with your own mat to the masjid also. Even this is a fortifications, 5 things. What about supplications, a dua? These things, I brought it from medical affairs. I'm not doctor, but they are advising us to make it, and we have to make it. The 5 ba'ad'iyah, supplications, and we will close the khutbah inshallah. 5 ad'iyah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanding us to make it. Number one, Al-Fatiha, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ الْمُعَوِّذَتَيْنِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. يبقى 4 حاجات. Al-Fatiha, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Every day, you have to say it. It's number one. Number two, this beautiful dua, بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. There is nothing in this dunya, in heaven or earth, can harm you without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the meaning of this dua. Bismillah الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. This is the second dua. The third dua, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق. I'm seeking refuge by the names of Allah, by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from that which is evil in the dunya. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. الإمام الشافعي was using this dua, the 4th dua. اللهم احفظني بحفظك الذي لا يرام واكلأني بعينك التي لا تنام ورد عني كيد الكائدين. Al-Imam Shafi'i says, if you say this dua and make tasbih to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the only thing will survive you from all these diseases. From especially awbi'a, pandemics. He said this. Allah's dua, the five dua, talking about al-awbi'a, pandemics. Especially dua, last one. Allahumma asrif anna hadha al-waba' bilutfika ya latif. Allahumma asrif anna hadha al-waba'. Waba' means pandemic. But now we're talking about a specific thing. Allahumma asrif anna, move away this pandemics from our life. This is the meaning of this dua. Allahumma asrif anna hadha al-waba' bilutfika ya latif. إنك على كل شيء قدير. يبقى خمسة دعاء. Five دعاء. Five supplications. الفاتحة. قل هو الله أحد. قل أعوذ برب الفلق. قل أعوذ برب الناس. Then أعوذ بكلمات. Then بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. Then أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. Then اللهم احفظني بحفظك الذي لا يرام واكلأني بعينك التي لا تنام ورد عني كيد الكائدين. Then اللهم اصرف عنا هذا الوباء بلطفك يا لطيف إنك على كل شيء قدير. رسول الله used also إنك على كل شيء قدير, which I talked in the beginning of the khutbah. You have to know that Allah على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم احفظنا بحفظك الذي لا يرام واكلأنا بعينك التي لا تنام ورد عنا كيد الكائدين وحسد الحاسدين برحمتك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اصرف عنا هذا الوباء. اللهم اصرف عنا هذا الوباء. اللهم اصرف عنا هذا الوباء برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إنك على كل شيء قدير. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا مقرؤا.